Hello guys, you're watching Droid Crunch and I'm Lokesh Kapoor, and in this video we are going to talk about how to show or hide any content based on the event trigger. So if someone clicks on a button, maybe the content will show, element will show or hide. So if you are looking to do this, then this is the video for you guys. Keep watching and let me know in comments how it worked for you. So let's get started really quickly. First of all, let me create I have already a testing page, so I will edit this page itself. Okay, for the purpose I will create two elements, one the button and one the main element that will be shown or hidden. So I can simply choose anything out of it, maybe this text. Okay, and a button, right? So this is the button which will make this text appear or disappear. So let me quickly move it to the center and keep this center line as well. Now it looks cool. I can name it show or hide, right? So let me just quickly go to this button and go to visibility. So to enable visibility, you need to install Dynamic.ooo, Dynamic Content for Elementor plugin. So this is a very cool plugin. Without installing this plugin, you cannot actually do this. So I am using Dynamic Visibility Event Trigger for this purpose. So you can download this plugin. There are tons of extensions and widgets that come in handy while making any kind of website, whether it use ACF toolkit or any other thing you might be looking to add in your website. So it is going to help you. So I'm doing this thing, user events, right? So let me go to this now, and here I will need to click on this section and or element, and I will enable visibility. It will show, and I will remove all except the events. To enable events, I will need to keep this to HTML, and on this I will need to click a trigger. What will be the trigger? I can name it anything. Possibly I can use it spaces ID. I will use toggle. And here I need to name it toggle, right? So show animation slide and toggle. When you have couple of elements or buttons, then you can use this hide other elements section. Like if you have three sections, three buttons like that, then you can put two others you want to hide at the same time when the one appears. So it can come in handy in that case. For now I am not using more than one, so I will keep this empty. And the trigger is toggle and it's not on page load, it will be on the click. So let's update this. Now let me quickly preview this page. Boom, it's working as I expected it to work, right guys? So this is how you can toggle any section in just couple of seconds. So I hope you just enjoyed this video, guys. For recap, I would like to know that to make this work, we will need to actually give it a ID and use the same ID in the events, right? With if selector, if it's a class then dot, if it's a ID then hash. So this is how it works. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this, and I will bring in more and more content regarding all kind of tutorials on WordPress and all those things. So just please subscribe. Till then, bye bye, have a wonderful day.